Good evening. My name is Daniel Flores, and I will be Master of Ceremonies this evening. I want to welcome everyone to PSJ North Early College High School Distinguished Level of Achievement with Collegiate Honors Banquet. Thank you to everyone for being here tonight as we honor these amazing students on this accomplishment. Before we begin with our ceremony, I would like to acknowledge and thank our choir director, Mr. McLeod, and his amazing students. His amazing students who most graciously entertain us during our prelude to this event. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, can everyone please rise for the presentation of the colors and remain standing for the Pledge of Allegiance and the invocation blessing. Tonight's presentation of the colors is being presented by the PSJ North Early College High School JROTC Color Guard. They are under the direction of Sergeant First Class Sebastian Rivera and Sergeant First Class George Brondo. The commander and presenting the United States flag is Cadet Sergeant Andrew Navarro. Presenting the flag is Cadet Private First Class Maritza Lozoya. The left guard is Cadet Private First Class Brian Rodriguez. And the right guard is Cadet Private First Class Yoslin Rodriguez. The Pledge of Allegiance will be recited by our salutatorian, Mr. Emiliano Rios.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, Emiliano. And now we will have our valedictorian, Ms. Evelyn Cuellar, bless us with the invocation.
Good evening, everyone, and thank you for being here. Let us bow our heads and close our eyes. Dear Heavenly Father, we are gathered here today, Lord, to celebrate a milestone in our young lives. We come before you in this evening to thank you for all you've done for us and the opportunities you've provided and will continue to provide. We thank you for this food, and we pray that you bless it and bless those who prepared it. Today, Lord, I ask that you guide everyone in this room to have the strength and courage to do their best in this world. Lord, if anyone here is feeling overwhelmed or worrying about the future or the situation they are in, I pray that you give them peace and freedom from their troubles. I ask that you equip us graduates with knowledge and wisdom as we seek a new chapter of our lives. I also ask that you protect and watch over our families, friends, teachers, and all those who have guided us along the way. May your will be done as we step into this new part of our lives. We know that all is done through your name, God, and that you have a specific plan for each and every one of us. In your name we pray, amen.
Amen. Thank you, Evelyn. You may now be seated. There are several people here tonight that are in attendance that we would like to recognize at this time. They honor us with events such as these and are instrumental in making sure our students achieve at every opportunity and level of success they can. Their undying commitment to serve our students, your children, is noticeable each and every day of the year. I would like to begin the introduction of our distinguished guests by asking that you please stand when I call your name. We begin with our school board members that are present here tonight. School board president, Mr. Carlos G. Villegas, Jr. And vice president, Ms. Diana Serna. and Secretary Ms. Yolanda Castillo. We also have members of our Central Office Administration here with us tonight. Dr. Alejandro Elias, Superintendent of Schools. He will also be addressing our guests in a few minutes. Here with us tonight, we also have Mr. Ranulfo Marquez. Rebecca Gonzalez. Dr. Rebecca Garza. Dr. Lauro Davalos. And Dr. Nora Cantu. Dr. Susana Arredondo. And Dr. Nora Rivas Garza. Our District Transition Specialist Department is here as well. Mr. Carlos Garcia, Director. And a few of the transition specialists, Mrs. Cristina Carrillo and Mr. Alonso Garcia. Last but not least, we do have our PSJ North Early College High School Administration and counseling staff to recognize. Principal Ms. Lisa Diaz. Early College Director Mr. Israel Nicanor. Assistant Principal Dr. Cristina Esparza. Assistant Principal Mr. Reynaldo Hernandez. Assistant Principal Dr. Selena Hoagland. Assistant Principal Mr. Roberto Perez. And our Dean of Instruction, Mrs. Laura Rodriguez. We would also like to introduce the Counseling Department. They do a tremendous job every day as part of the campus-based staff that our district entrusts your children with. Not only do they play a huge role in the curriculum of our students, guidance for high school requirements and college admittance, but they also delve into many other areas our students may need assistance with. The PSJ North Early College High School Counseling Department is led by Mrs. Rocio Guajardo, head counselor. Counselors, Mrs. Maria Alcantar. Mrs. Denise Alonso. Mrs. Valerie Arenas. Ms. Jennifer Cassiano. And Mrs. Giselle Guzman. We also have in our attendance our financial aid officer, Ms. Alyssa Dorado. Ms. Dorado has been very instrumental in the college and financial process of our students. It is my great pleasure to ask Mrs. Lisa Diaz, PSJ North Early College High School Principal, to come up and present the welcome address.
Good evening, Raider family. I am Lisa Villas, principal here at PSJ North Early College High School. I welcome all of you to this year's Distinguished Level of Achievement with Collegiate Honors Assembly, honoring the academic accolades of the class of 2024. I would like to acknowledge and thank our distinguished school board of trustees, our school board president, Mr. Carlos Villegas, our superintendent of schools, Dr. Alejandro Elias, and our senior staff for their continued support and visionary leadership. Additionally, I would like to acknowledge and thank PSJ North Early College High School's administration, counselors, and faculty for their unwavering commitment in preparing and assisting each and every one of these students during their journey towards post-secondary success. Finally, I would like to thank all of the parents. You are the primary pillars of support for our students. They have excelled with you always by their side. As principal, I am sincerely humbled and honored to celebrate the accolades of our top academic scholars. Distinguished class of 2024, you have demonstrated your resounding resiliency through rigorous academics by remaining steadfast and focused to continue paving a solid foundation for your future. Your strength, spirit, and tenacity has demonstrated how resilient you are. Many of you balanced your high school courses and STC courses alongside multiple extracurricular activities. This further proves how well-rounded you are and genuinely prepared to face the upcoming and new chapter of your life. You will be our future's astounding community leaders, and you deserve recognition for all of your accomplishments. Out of 555 seniors, 104 of you are graduating under our district's Distinguished Level of Achievement with Collegiate Honors Graduation Plan. I am proud to announce that 76 of you graduated with your associate degree from our higher education partner, South Texas College, before graduating from high school. We also have 28 of you who completed your required core college credits with over 42 hours. Scholars, as a senior class of 2024, you have committed yourself to leaving a successful collegiate legacy at PSJ North Early College High School. Always remain prideful, yet sincerely humble in showcasing your hard work, talents, and academic accolades. It is with great pride I humbly congratulate each one of you. Thank you, God bless you, and long live PSJ North.
Thank you, Ms. Diaz, for being the guiding force for PSJ North Early College High School and for being an amazing instrument and advocate for all students and staff. You truly encompass what it means to be part of the PSJ family. Now it is my honor to introduce PSJ's Superintendent, Dr. Alejandro Elias.
Good evening to everyone. First of all, congratulations to the students that are here. 104, that's the biggest class we've done up to now with DLACH. What does it mean? What does it mean to be DLACH? Aside from all the sacrifices that these students have done, one is to be at least core complete or to have their associate's degree. No other district does what PSJ does. One is to guide and support the students. Two, that nobody else has DLACH. That's an honor that nowhere in the state of Texas do they have this. So that means that the rigor was set very high for these 104 students. And to be able to complete and be part of DLACH is a huge honor. I know your parents, your family members are very proud of you. But that says that you're ready to go out there and conquer anything that sits in front of you. You're gonna be out there at a college, university, but still remember that PSJA is family. PSJA is here to make sure that you're going to succeed. Your success is your family's success, and it's PSJA success also. So students, I know that out there you have a little card that's out there. Parents, please hold on to that. Students, hold on to it. We have our transitional advisors, which is Carlos Garcia, Alonso Garcia, and Ms. Carrillo that are here. If y'all would like to stand up, they are the people that are gonna be key in your success also. If you hit a barrier out there, or you need guidance, or you need support, PSJA is still here as your family. PSJA will make sure that as soon as you call, as soon as you email them, we're gonna be there to support you. Remember your counselors, your financial aid officer. Even if you're a year or two into your postgraduate, let's say you're working on your master's degree, because most of you, in a year and a half, you're gonna get your bachelor's degree, and that's a for sure. So after that, your master's, we're still gonna be here as PSJ family to continue to guide you, to continue to make sure that you're gonna succeed. So reach out to them. They're here for that. Everybody's here to support you, cheer you on, and make sure that you're gonna complete, because you're the future leaders for PSJA. You're the future leaders for the communities. And when I say PSJA, it means the three cities that we are part of. You're the leaders. You might be the next superintendent, the next doctor that's gonna come back and give back to the communities that you're here from. Also, as students, I wanna assure that we are gonna be here. And I can tell you that, because that's what I want for every student. I want every one of you, all 104 of you, to succeed and then come back and give back, give your stories as an alumni of PSJA, give your stories so that others may follow in your footsteps. You're the role models. You're setting that pace for everybody else to make sure that they follow in the same footsteps. So again, parents, we're very proud of your sons, your daughters here at PSJA. Students, congratulations. I know pretty soon many of you already graduated from STC, but pretty soon, this coming weekend, you'll be walking also as graduates from PSJA. Be proud of this moment, celebrate it, but at the same time, start thinking of what your goals are and set those goals so that you may complete them in your near future. Again, may God bless you all. And congratulations, and power to Raiders.
Thank you, Dr. Elias. Would Mr. Carlos Villegas, School Board President, please come up and share a few words on behalf of the board?
First of all, let me assure each and every one of us here today that we recognize and we're proud of the fact that you students are graduating from the number one high school in the state of Texas. A big applause. You're graduating from the number one district in the state of Texas. We are so blessed to have leadership all the way from the top, our superintendent, our administrative staff, and then all the components that assure that our students are going to have the best future possible. And that includes our campus leadership, Mrs. Lisa Diaz, and all your staff, your counselors, your assistant principals, and especially all you teachers out there. But it takes two other components to get you where you are today, students. It takes your family and all the sacrifices that I have made throughout the years since you were a toddler to make sure that they would be able 12 or 13 years later, 17 years later, or sit here and be so immensely proud of what you have accomplished. Just think about that. You've gotten half of your college career out of the way. the expensive things that go along after a post-secondary education. You got some of that stuff out of the way. And Dr. Elias said it right. Throughout the state of Texas, everybody comes to PSJA and asks us, how do you do this? Well, it just takes a passion for our students and creativity and a lot of praying, and we're here. So I want to congratulate you students for taking advantage of being some of the top students in our entire district. But more than anything else, I want to make sure you understand that the one component that says the reason that you're here is you yourself, students. For all the sacrifices that you made, for all the late hours studying, like was said before, Principal Lisa Diaz said, to balance a day with extracurricular activities and homework and still be one of 100 plus top graduating students of your class. That's no easy task. But remember that this is only a step in that journey that you're going to have starting after graduation that's going to hopefully guide you in that direction you want for the next 50, 60, 70 years of your life. It's only a milestone up until graduation, but dream big. Look for those other milestones that are out there for you. And you know you have failed. Each and every one of us in this room tonight have failed. Whether it's our superintendent, whether it's Carlos Villegas, our principal, our teachers, growing up and going through the same thing that you all are going through tonight, we all failed, but we didn't give up. We got up, we dusted ourselves, and we went forward. Choose the right path. The journey is long, but it's achievable. So choose the right path. You have gone over so many hurdles to get here. There are a few more. No matter how high, jump over them. Don't give up. We are immensely proud that all of you Raiders tonight are graduating with this distinguished honor. We look forward to seeing you at graduation. God bless you, and remember, always come back to us. We'll be here to help you. God bless.
Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to introduce our keynote speaker who will share some words of wisdom to our students as they begin their journey for their future. Matthew Ray Alvarado is an engineer currently serving as the head broadcast engineer for the University of Texas Athletics Department. In his first year at UT, Matthew managed over $30 million in technology projects. His most notable project to date is leading the design and project management of a new $22 million state-of-the-art IPTV production studio that will produce live venue shows for ESPN and UT Athletics. Before his time at the University of Texas, Matt was the chief engineer for the NFL's Arizona Cardinals. During his time with the Cardinals, Matthew was the chief engineer for Super Bowl 37. My Roman numerals are horrible. Where he managed the technical operations of the production control room. Matt accomplished this with the help of his team of 20 students from Glendale Community College, which he taught and mentored in the process of building a control room. Matt is a native of Far Texas, graduated from PSJ North Early College High School in 2016. He then pursued his passion for broadcasting at Texas A&M University, where he graduated with a bachelor's degree. His career in broadcasting took off at the athletics department's 12th Man Productions. As a student of Texas A&M, Matt was driven by his passion to learn the value of hard work, which allowed him to enhance his creative and critical thinking skills, paving the way for his success. Today, he resides in Austin, Texas, where he aspires to continue mentoring the next generation of creative problem solvers, a journey sure to inspire admiration. I present to you Mr. Matthew Alvarado.
Good evening, esteemed guests, faculty members, and parents, most importantly, the class of 2024. It's a tremendous honor to have been invited to speak here today on this momentous occasion, celebrating your academic achievements and growth as individuals. It's a day of celebration, reflection, and anticipation for the journey ahead. As I began to prepare what I would say tonight, I could not help but reflect on my journey over the past year as a head broadcast engineer at the University of Texas and what I have learned along the way. I figured the best advice I could give is to give some insights into the things I have learned. As a head broadcast engineer, I'm responsible for the design and construction of a brand new $22 million TV production studio that will broadcast all the sporting events on campus and on the ESPN networks. This is a brand new journey for the athletics department as we join the Southeastern Conference and take over the Longhorn Network. It sure felt like a new start when I arrived on campus. As the fall season was approaching, I had to figure out how to put on a video board show at the new Moody Center for basketball's debut. This was an interesting challenge for me, as this was the second time I was starting a season within a new control room, and let's just say the last time it was not a success. It gave me flashbacks to my first NFL game with the Arizona Cardinals, where the main device that's responsible for providing video across the stadium failed right before kickoff. I would not say this was the only instance where I failed to have a flawless show, but that was the case. My time in Arizona was filled with highs and lows. Looking back at where I am today, I'm very appreciative of the times I have failed. For many, they interpret failure as negative, and at the time, I did too. But failure can be a positive thing when you evaluate the situation and learn something from it. As you all begin your own journeys, you too will fail, but it's not the amount of times that you fail that's important, it's how you respond to the situation. Other times in life, you will face issues that do not have straightforward outcomes. I'm fortunate enough to have the opportunity to teach students across many different majors that are interested in sports broadcasting. Although some of them may not want to be a broadcast engineer post-graduation, I like to tell each of them that the most important skill they can learn is how to be a creative problem solver. As a broadcast engineer, it is my responsibility to ensure that each game makes it on national television so that the fans and viewers at home are able to cheer on their favorite teams. However, not every game is as smooth as it seems. And as we all know, technology always seems to have some sort of issue. But unfortunately, if there are issues, I cannot say, well, sorry, I tried. We are not broadcasting a game today. Instead, I have to think quickly on my feet and find a solution to make sure we make it on the air. Life is a lot like a broadcast. At times, you will run into a problem that you just cannot avoid, and you have to find a creative solution to get through it. Now, life isn't all about the struggles you will face, but also the people that you face them with. One of my greatest accomplishments to date was being the chief engineer for Super Bowl 57. This was a bittersweet accomplishment for me because not only was I able to manage one of the world's biggest sporting events of the year, but I was also able to upgrade the production control room to the newest technology just 3 weeks before the big event. Not only did people think we were crazy for doing this in such a tight timeline, but to use an untested system for the biggest event of the year was unheard of. When we started the project, I knew I couldn't do it on my own. Even though at first it was hard to entrust others with such great responsibility, I knew I had to. So I set out to train 20 students from Glendale Community College to help build the system. Yes, at first it was a little more work for me, but in the end it paid off. Not only were we able to divide and conquer and complete the project on time, but there were 20 people on our team that had gained knowledge about the latest broadcast technology. As you all go on to be leaders, do not be afraid to share your knowledge with others. Surround yourself with people that will help you grow. Sorry, one second. Surround yourself with people that will help you grow, because no one can achieve greatness alone. And now onto the most important thing that I've learned in my journey. Passion. If you would have asked me 6 years ago, while I was sitting at this banquet, if I would be a broadcast engineer, I would have looked at you funny. I always had this crazy idea of working in production and managing some of the biggest events, but at the time, it seemed like it was an impossible feat, so instead, I decided I would go get a degree to what I deemed was more attainable. Luckily for me, I found my way back to what I was passionate about before it was too late. As you all get ready to start your own journey, I encourage you to follow your dreams and find a career in something that you are passionate about. Explore careers in the areas that you are interested in, because there are probably more careers out there than you think. Parents, I encourage you to support your son and daughter as they go out to pursue their dreams. I know at times it may be hard to see them leave home, because it was hard for my parents, but I wouldn't be able to accomplish all that I have without their support. Class of 2024, as you begin your next chapter in your life, remember, dreams alone are not enough. They must be accompanied by hard work, dedication, and willingness to embrace change and growth. As you navigate life's journey, be open to new opportunities, new experiences, and new perspectives. And never be afraid to step outside of your comfort zone. Congratulations, class of 2024.
Don't go anywhere. Thank you, Mr. Alvarado. On behalf of PSJ North Early College High School, we have a small token of appreciation for you. It is now that time that we have all gathered here for tonight, and that is to honor those students who have earned the recognition of being a distinguished level of achievement with collegiate honors graduates.
Our first DLACH student is Dulce Judith Aguirre Zumaya. She is the daughter of Mr. Jose Aguirre. She earned an Associate of Arts in Education. Dulce will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and will major in early childhood education. Davian Matthew Alanis, son of Mr. David Alanis and Mrs. Claudette Alanis. He earned an Associate of Arts in Criminal Justice. Davian will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and will major in political science. Sergio Alejandro Aparicio, son of Mr. and Mrs. Aparicio. He has earned 51 hours of college credit and is graduating core complete. He will attend the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and will major in exercise science. Luisa Trinidad Ayar, daughter of Mr. David Ayar and Ms. Maria Tostado. She earned an Associate of Arts in Interdisciplinary Studies. Lisa will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and will major in psychology. Luisa. Rochelle Leanne Campos, daughter of Richard Campos and Gladys de la Garza. She earned an Associate of Arts in Criminal Justice. Rochelle will be entering the workforce. Daniel Castillo Jr., son of Mr. Daniel Castillo and Ms. Sarah Laredo. He earned an Associate of Arts in Criminal Justice. Daniel will be attending Texas State University and will major in criminal justice. Andrea Castro Cano, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Castro. She has earned 45 hours of college credit and is graduating core complete. She will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and will major in business. Jaslyn Victoria Cerron, daughter of Mr. Victor Cerron and Ms. Sandra Socio. She earned an Associate of Art in Interdisciplinary Studies. Jaslyn will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and will major in biology. Moses Manuel Cortina, son of Ms. Irma Perales. He has earned 42 hours of college credit and is graduating core complete. He will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and will major in kinesiology. Sebastian Estrada, son of Mrs. Dayanara Resendez. He earned an Associate's of Arts in Interdisciplinary Studies. Sebastian will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and will major in nursing. Jaden Davin Fuentes, son of Mrs. Mari Lopez and Mr. Daniel Fuentes. He has earned 42 hours of college credit and is graduating core complete. He will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and will major in kinesiology. Mr. Daniel Garcia Jr., son of Mr. Daniel Garcia and Ms. Nadia Aguirre. He has earned 42 hours of college credit and is graduating core complete. He will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and will major in criminal justice. Dante Garcia, son of Ms. Nadia Aguirre and Mr. Daniel Garcia. He has earned 45 hours of college credit and is graduating core complete. He will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and will major in criminal justice. Jason Nicholas Garcia, son of Ms. Leticia Garcia and Mr. Eduardo Garcia. He earned an Associate's of Science in Biology. Jason will be attending South Texas College and will major in nursing. Kendra Michelle Gonzalez, daughter of Mr. Isai Gonzalez and Ms. Ruby Gonzalez. She earned an Associate's of Arts in Criminal Justice. Kendra will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and will major in psychology. Esteban Guerra, son of Mr. Daniel Guerra and Ms. Maria Guerra. He earned an Associate's of Science in Interdisciplinary Studies. Esteban will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and will major in mechanical engineering. Marco Guerra, son of Juan and Maria Guerra. He has earned 45 hours of college credit and is graduating core complete. He will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and will major in music education. Jimena Jimenez, daughter of Mr. Luciano Jimenez and Ms. Claudia Jimenez. She earned an Associate's of Arts in Interdisciplinary Studies. Jimena will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and will major in mechanical engineering. Emmanuel Juarez, son of Mr. Javier Juarez and Ms. Maria Quintanilla. He earned an Associate's of Arts in Interdisciplinary Studies. Emmanuel will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and will major in music education. Mariana Lopez, daughter of Ms. Garza. She earned an Associate's of Arts in Interdisciplinary Studies. Mariana will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and will major in early childhood education. Arturo Elias Lopez de la Cruz, son of Ms. Ermelinda de la Cruz. He earned an Associate's of Arts in Interdisciplinary Studies. Arturo will be attending Texas A&M Corpus Christi and will major in business administration. Christy Anna Grace Luera, daughter of Miss Juliana Luera. She has earned 45 hours of college credit and is graduating core complete. She will be attending Texas A&M University in San Antonio and will major in interdisciplinary studies. Victoria Faith Magallan, daughter of Mr. Rafael Magallan and Miss Jessica Martinez. She earned an Associate's of Science in Biology. Victoria will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and will major in biology. Rolando A. Martinez Jr., son of Marta Martinez and Esteban Montano. He has earned 49 hours of college credit and is graduating core complete. He will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and will major in psychology. Andre Timothy Matamoros, son of Arlene Rocha and Jay Matamoros. He has earned 48 hours of college credit and is graduating core complete. He will be attending the University of Incarnate Word and will major in kinesiology. Emily Mendoza, daughter of Miss Rosa Medina. She earned an Associate's of Arts in Interdisciplinary Studies. Emily will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and will major in business management. Joanna Monsevais, daughter of Ms. Juani Monsevais and Mr. Hector Monsevais. She earned an Associate's of Arts in Interdisciplinary Studies. Joanna will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and will major in Applied Technology in Health Science. Deliza Angelique Orellano, daughter of Ms. Angelina Alvarado. She has earned an Associate's of Arts in Interdisciplinary Studies. She will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and will major in Criminal Justice. Ronaldo Eto Orozco, son of Ms. Mariana Orozco and Mr. Jose Orozco. He earned an Associate's of Arts in Business Administration. Ronaldo will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and will major in Business Administration. Daniel Giovanni Horta Massa, son of Mr. Daniel Horta and Ms. Aida Massa. He has earned 45 hours of college credit and is graduating core complete. He will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and will major in music education. Mr. Edwin Gilberto Perez, son of Mr. Oscar Zamora and Ms. Miriam Perez. He has earned an Associate's of Arts in Criminal Justice. Edwin will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and will major in Criminal Justice. Alex Perez Segundo, son of Mr. Arturo Perez and Ms. Liza Perez. He has earned 42 hours of college credit and is graduating core complete. He will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and will major in mechanical engineering. Vanessa Picon Salazar, daughter of Mr. Marco Antonio and Ms. Claudia Salazar. She has earned an Associate's of Arts in Criminal Justice. Vanessa will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and will major in Criminal Justice. Esmeralda Ponce, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Ponce. She has earned 42 hours of college credit and is graduating core complete. She will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and will major in nursing. Cassandra Prado, daughter of Ms. Lorraine Prado. She has earned an Associate's of Science in Interdisciplinary Studies. Cassandra will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and will major in biology. Ailema Anit Reyes, daughter of Mr. Jose Rodriguez and Ms. Christina Rodriguez. She has earned an Associate of Arts in Interdisciplinary Studies. Ailema will be attending the University of Houston and will major in anthropology. Charlene Marie Reyes, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Ricardo Alejandro. She earned an Associate of Arts in Sociology. Charlene will be attending Our Lady of the Lake University and will major in psychology. Isaac Anthony Rivera, son of Mr. and Mrs. Marco Reyes, has earned 45 hours of college credit and is graduating core complete. He will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and will major in computer science. Michaela Jade Romero, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Michael Reyes. She has earned an Associate of Arts in Interdisciplinary Studies. Michaela will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and will major in early childhood education. Jonathan Tristan Romo, son of Mr. and Mrs. Romo. He has earned 42 hours of college credit and is graduating core complete. He will be attending the University of Texas at Austin and will major in accounting. Adan Salinas, son of Mr. Fernando Salinas and Ms. Rafaela Ramirez. He has earned 49 hours of college credit and is graduating core complete. He will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and will major in business. Salvador Sanchez Jr., son of Salvador and Elizabeth Sanchez. He earned an Associate of Arts in Interdisciplinary Studies. Salvador will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and will major in accounting. Josue Sandoval II, son of Mr. Josue Sandoval and Ms. Alejandra Sandoval. He has earned an Associate of Arts in Interdisciplinary Studies. Josue will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and will major in cybersecurity. Luis Alberto Serna III, son of Estefanie Garza, has earned 46 hours of college credit and is graduating core complete. He will be attending the University of Texas at San Antonio and will major in marketing. Sebastian Torres, son of Mr. Jose Francisco Torres and Ms. Ruth Torres. He earned an Associate of Arts in Interdisciplinary Studies. Sebastian will be attending the College of the Holy Cross and will major in political science and psychology. Mr. Joe Derek Vecchio, son of Mr. and Mrs. Vecchio. He has earned 42 hours of college credit and is graduating core complete. He will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and will major in business. We will now introduce the graduate candidates ranking in the top 10% of their class. Starting with Brianna Sarmiento, daughter of Mr. Jose Sarmiento and Mrs. Nieves Villa. She earned an Associate of Arts in Interdisciplinary Studies. Brianna will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande and psychology. Rank number 52, we have Carlos Adrian Guerra Jr., son of Ms. Gina Garza and Mr. Isaac Talavera. He earned an Associate of Arts in Interdisciplinary Studies. Carlos will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and will major in biology. Ranked number 51, we have Tariana Jade Ruiz, a daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Silvano Ruiz. She has earned 45 hours of college credit and is graduating core complete. She'll be attending Sam Houston State University and will major in education. Ranked number 50, we have Galilea Palomo, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Lila Palomo. She has earned 45 hours of college credit and is graduating core complete. She will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and will major in early childhood education. Ranked number 49, we have Marcus Jonathan Rendon, son of Mr. Mark Rendon and Miss Erica Rendon. He has earned 45 college credits and is graduating core complete. He will be attending Texas Lutheran University and will major in exercise science. Ranked number 47 is Iram Alejandro Hernandez, son of Mr. Jesus Hernandez and Ms. Maribel Hernandez. He earned an Associate's of Arts in Criminal Justice. Iram will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and will major in Criminal Justice. Ranked number 46 is Mr. Robert Aiden Sanchez, son of Ms. Aida Vela and Mr. Robert Sanchez. He earned an Associate's of Arts in Interdisciplinary Studies. Robert will be attending Texas A&M University and will major in biology. Ranked number 45, we have Emily Grace Trevino, daughter of Mr. Hector Trevino and Ms. Mirna Trevino. She earned an Associate's of Arts in Interdisciplinary Studies. Emily will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and will major in English. Ranked number 44 is Brianna Isabel Vasquez, daughter of Desi Martinez. She earned an Associate's of Arts in Interdisciplinary Studies. Brianna will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and will major in Criminal Justice with a minor in Kinesiology. Number 43 is Rebecca Ann Flores, daughter of Anna and Noe Flores. She has earned 48 hours of college credit and is graduating core complete. She will be attending the University of Texas at Austin and will major in kinesiology. Rank number 43 is Haley Faith Hernandez, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Jose Hernandez Jr. She earned an Associate's of Science in Biology. Haley will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and will major in biomedical science. Rank number 42 is Emily Isela Sanchez, daughter of Mr. Ricardo Sanchez and Ms. Maricela Guerrero. She earned an Associate's of Arts in Interdisciplinary Studies. Emily will be attending South Texas College and will major in business. Rank number 41 is Luciano James Lopez, son of Luciano Lopez and Evie Tijerina. He earned an Associate's of Arts in Interdisciplinary Studies. Luciano will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and will major in marketing. Rank number 40 is Carla Montserrat Valles, daughter of Mr. Carlos Valles and Ms. Claudia Lopez. She has earned an Associate's of Arts in Interdisciplinary Studies. Carla will be attending Texas A&M University Higher Education Center and will major in nursing. Rank number 39 is Christopher Ociel Serna, son of Mr. Mario Garcia and Ms. Oralia Garcia. He has earned an Associate's of Arts in Criminal Justice. Christopher will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and will major in Criminal Justice. Ranked number 38 is Juan Ignacio Badillo Perez, son of Ms. Carla Perez and Mr. Sergio Badillo. He has earned 42 college credit hours and is graduating core complete. He will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and will major in electrical engineering. Number 37 is Gabrielle Vianney Ibarra, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Ibarra. She has earned an Associate of Arts in Interdisciplinary Studies. Gabrielle will be attending the University of Texas at Austin and will major in audiology. Erendira Estrada, daughter of Mr. Felipe Estrada and Mrs. Erendira Munoz Estrada. She has earned an Associate of Arts in Interdisciplinary Studies. She will be attending the University of Texas, Rio Grande Valley, and will major in biomedical science. Ranked number 35 is Ana Delay Garza Pruneda, daughter of Mr. Emerardo Pruneda and Ms. Amabeli Pruneda. She has earned an Associate of Arts in Interdisciplinary Studies. She will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and will major in biomedical science. Ranked number 34 is Osvaldo Escaret Rico, son of Mr. Antelmo Rico and Ms. Noelia Escobar. He earned an Associate of Science in Interdisciplinary Studies. He will be attending the University of Texas, Rio Grande Valley, and will major in electrical engineering. Rank number 33 is Azalea Guerrero, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Guerrero. She has earned 48 hours of college credit and is graduating core complete. She'll be attending South Texas College and will major in diagnostic medical sonography. Ranked number 32 is Christian Jaciel Morales, son of Mr. and Mrs. Morales. He has earned an Associate of Science in Interdisciplinary Studies. Christian will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and will major in mechanical engineering. Rank number 31 is Eileen Yasmin Zavala, daughter of Mr. Jesus and Ms. Cristina Cevada. She has earned an Associate of Arts in Interdisciplinary Studies. Eileen will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and will major in biology. Number 30 is Ms. Daniela Eileen Vela, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Vela. She has earned an Associate of Arts in Interdisciplinary Studies. Daniela will be attending South Texas College and will major in ultrasound technician. Number 29 is Ms. Aliyah Marie Perez, daughter of Mr. Jose Perez and Ms. Griselda Perez. She has earned an Associate of Arts in Interdisciplinary Studies. She will be attending the University of Texas at Austin and will major in kinesiology. Number 28 is Mandalee Ramirez, daughter of Mr. Armando Ramirez Jr. and Ms. Mandy Gonzalez. She has earned 45 hours of college credit and is graduating core complete. She will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and will major in kinesiology. Rank number 27 is Isabella Yvette Tagle, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Trevino. She has earned an Associate of Arts in Interdisciplinary Studies. Isabella will be attending the University of Texas at San Antonio and will major in biology. Rank number 26 is Vanessa Martinez, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Canuto Martinez Jr. She has earned an Associate of Arts in Interdisciplinary Studies. Vanessa will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and will major in nursing. Rank number 25 is Auric Alex Ayala, son of Mr. Antonio Ayala and Ms. Normalinda Ayala. He has earned 52 hours of college credit and is graduating core complete. He will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and will major in biomedical science. Rank number 24 is Sofia Salinas, daughter of Mr. Jesus Ruben Salinas and Ms. Adela Salinas. She has earned an Associate of Arts in Interdisciplinary Studies. Sofia will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and will major in biology. Rank number 23 is Gabriel Eduardo Gonzalez, son of Mr. Hector Gonzalez and Ms. Andrea Gonzalez. He earned an Associate of Arts in Interdisciplinary Studies. Gabriel will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and will major in computer science. Rank number 22 is Americo Quintanilla Jr., son of Mr. Americo and Ms. Olga Lidia Quintanilla. He has earned 42 hours of college credit and is graduating core complete. He will be attending Texas A&M University and will major in visualization. Rank number 21 is Emily Kiko Ramos, daughter of Ms. Sylvia Rodriguez and Mr. Ramos. She earned an Associate of Arts in Interdisciplinary Studies. Emily will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and will major in biomedical science. Rank number 20 is Emerice Giselle Bautista, daughter of Ms. Pamela Barbosa. She earned an Associate of Arts in Criminal Justice. She will be attending the University of Texas San Antonio and will major in Criminal Justice. Rank number 19 is Kevin Gonzalez, son of Mr. and Mrs. Gonzalez. He earned an Associate of Arts in Interdisciplinary Studies. Kevin will be attending Texas A&M University and will major in computer science. Rank number 18 is Jaylene Gonzalez, daughter of Mr. Rory Gonzalez and Ms. Yesenia Gonzalez. She earned an Associate of Arts in Interdisciplinary Studies. Jaylene will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and will major in nursing. Rank number 17 is Alan Ruiz, a son of Mr. Martin Ruiz and Ms. Susana Ruiz. He has earned 45 hours of college credit and is graduating core complete. He will be attending the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley and will major in theater. Rank number 16 is Isaac Cecilio Willingham, son of Mr. Patrick Willingham and Ms. Marvy Willingham. He earned an Associate of Arts in Interdisciplinary Studies. Isaac will be attending St. Mary's University and will major in Communication Studies. Rank number 15 is Genesis Sky Ramirez, daughter of Ms. Robin Watts. She earned an Associate of Arts in Interdisciplinary Studies. Genesis will be attending Texas State University and will major in Public Health. Rank number 14 is Karen Valderas Vidal, daughter of Mr. Vidal and Ms. Valderas. She has earned an Associate of Arts in Interdisciplinary Studies. Karen will be attending Texas A&M University Kingsville and will major in biology. Rank number 13 is Debony Figueroa, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Figueroa. She earned an Associate's of Arts in Criminal Justice. Debony will be attending the University of Texas at Austin and will major in government. Ranked number 12 is Jasmine Garza, daughter of Mrs. Vanessa Garza and Jacob Garza. She earned an Associate's of Science in Interdisciplinary Studies. Jasmine will be attending the University of Texas, Rio Grande Valley, and will major in biomedical sciences. Ranked number 11 is Mr. Ethan Gume Hernandez, son of Mr. and Mrs. Jason and Marisa Hernandez. He has earned an Associate's of Arts in Interdisciplinary Studies. Ethan will be attending the University of California, Los Angeles, and will major in biology. Our number 10 graduate is Jacqueline Gonzalez, daughter of Asencio Gonzalez and Mrs. Ether Gonzalez. She earned an Associate's of Arts in Education. Jacqueline will be attending the University of Texas, Rio Grande Valley, and will major in early childhood education. Ranked number 9 is Isabel Clarissa Espinosa, daughter of Mr. Freddy Espinosa and Miss Fanny Espinosa. She earned an Associate's of Science in Interdisciplinary Studies. Isabel will be attending the University of Texas, Rio Grande Valley, and will major in Nutritional Sciences. Ranked number 8 is Leandra Denise de Hoyos, daughter of Ms. Cristina Ramirez and Mr. Ruben de Hoyos. She earned an Associate's of Arts in Education. Leandra will be attending Texas A&M University and will major in mathematics for secondary teaching. Ranked number 7 is Jimena Trejo, daughter of Ms. Carla Araguz and Mr. Oscar Mijares. She earned an Associate's of Arts in Criminal Justice. Jimena will be attending Texas A&M University and will major in business. Ranked number 6 is Camila Nicole Gonzalez Lara, daughter of Ms. Olga Gonzalez. She earned an Associate's of Arts in Interdisciplinary Studies. Camila will be attending the University of Texas at Austin and will major in early childhood bilingual education. Rank number 4 is Ms. Ruby Alexandra Trevino, daughter of Maria V. Santana and Esaul Gonzalez. She earned an Associate's of Arts in Interdisciplinary Studies. Ruby will be attending Texas A&M University and will major in nursing. Rank number 3 is Benito Montemayor III, son of Ricardo Montemayor and Carla Montemayor. He earned an Associate's of Arts in English. He will be attending Rice University and will major in English. At this time, if everybody could please stand so that we can congratulate our 2023-2024 salutatorian. Mr. Emiliano Sebastian Rios, son of Mr. Artemio and Ms. Alvarado. He earned an Associate's of Science in Computer Science. Emiliano will be attending the University of Texas at Austin and will major in computer science. And now we present to you our 2023-2024 PSJ North Early College High School valedictorian, Ms. Evelyn Denise Cuellar. She is the daughter of Mrs. Elizabeth and Mr. Pedro Cuellar. She earned an Associate's of Arts in Interdisciplinary Studies. Evelyn will be attending the University of Texas at Rio Grande Valley and will major in business administration.
We have come to the conclusion of tonight's events. It has been a great honor to have each and every one of you in attendance tonight and to see the amazing young men and women who are recognized tonight. Special thanks to our keynote speaker, Mr. Matthew Alvarado, our PSJ North Early College High School administration, Ms. Lisa Diaz, the entire administration staff, counseling staff, choir department, JROTC program, PSJA ISD Public Relations, and our ISD print shop. Students, keep striving for greatness, and we look forward to having you come back to serve your PSJA community. Have a safe drive home and good night.
Oh, thank you.